Well, it is reasonably well prepared. Most of the country had the pandemic preparedness plan already on the table, and so they start implementing them. We see, of course, differences between countries and countries, but at the moment there's also differences in the epidemic level among countries. Now, there's countries like Italy where the community transmission is pretty widespread, and other countries that are reporting only a few imported cases. But the preparation plans are mostly in place. We have a plan with four different scenarios according to the level of the epidemic, from very few cases here and there to a full-scale epidemic that has a big impact on the healthcare systems, and with a staggered response according to the state of the epidemic in your own country.
We do not know what will happen as China gets back to work, but China outside of the epicenter of this appears to be succeeding in its efforts at the moment to curtail the spread. Is there anything Europe can learn from China, or actually because of the demographic setup, because of the way that the state is run compared with European democracies, is it impossible to replicate containment measures?
Well, the containment measures that they use in China had been extremely drastic. I have difficulties in seeing European member states being able to apply the same level of constraint, if you want, on movement, on trade, on health services. It's going to be difficult to replicate in Europe what has been done in China. There's also a word of caution here. China is reporting fewer and fewer cases, but the decrease in cases has been very sudden. They have changed case definitions, so we have to wait and see if this decrease in cases is completely real or it's an artifact of the surveillance.
Sergio, there seem to have been two different approaches to the way that these outbreaks have been dealt with. China and Italy have gone for these very extreme quarantines of towns and locations, but we've not seen that pattern repeated in other countries who've been prepared just to deal with case-by-case outbreaks. Which do you think will be most effective in dealing with this, and which do you think your organization would recommend to governments?
Well, as I said before, we have four set of recommendations according to the stage of the epidemic in your country. We are seeing more and more countries getting into what we call the scenario three, with quite widespread community transmission. And in that situation, together with the attempts of containment, identifying cases, isolating and so on, there is the need of starting mitigation, delay and mitigation measures, social distancing, the washing of hands, the preparedness inside the hospitals, the attention to the emergency services, the protection of healthcare workers, the personal protection equipment availability. These are all things that have to be implemented in countries that more and more will see community transmission.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.